If you don't live in an English-speaking country, it can be hard to make progress because you don't have many opportunities to use English in your regular daily life. So, what can you do if you're not surrounded by English? I have some good news. There are ways you can make English a regular part of your life, even if you don't live in an English-speaking country. Here are my top six ways to make English part of your everyday life. They don't require a lot of time, just a few simple changes. Number one is to read or listen to the news in English. I recommend spending 15 minutes every morning, and there are several great sites for this. You can use a site made specifically for English learners, like learningenglish.voanews.com. There's also the BBC's Learning English section, as well as breakingnewsenglish.com. Or, if you're a little more advanced, you can get your news from sites for native speakers, like CNN, BBC, or news.google.com. Just make sure to select the US edition so you'll get all the articles in English. The second way to make English a regular part of your life is to listen to podcasts while you travel, exercise, while you're waiting, etc. This way, you can take advantage of time that's normally wasted and use it to improve your English, especially your listening. There are many podcasts for English learners, like ESL Pod, All Ears English, English Fluency Now, Go Natural English, and of course the Espresso English Podcast. Or you can listen to regular podcasts made for native speakers, which are in your areas of interest. This is important because you'll enjoy the process of practicing your listening more if you're listening to a topic that you're interested in. My third tip is very important for fluency. It's to practice thinking in English during the day. This doesn't have to be difficult or complicated. Anytime you have a spare minute, just look around you and think some simple sentences in English about what you see. It's a great way to practice a fluency skill without needing any textbooks, equipment, or lots of time. Now, what about speaking? Here are three ways you can practice your speaking, even if you don't live in an English-speaking country. First of all, you can read aloud. This is good just to practice forming the words and improve your pronunciation, and it helps build your confidence to speak in English. The next thing you can do is talk to yourself. This might seem a little ridiculous, but it's actually very good for training your ability to speak spontaneously in English. You can practice answering conversation questions like the ones at the link below. Just look at a question and imagine that someone has asked you, and respond by speaking aloud in English. Remember, if you make a mistake, it's okay because nobody's around to hear you. And finally, I highly recommend getting a speaking partner online. You can join a conversation exchange website where you'll find other people who are interested in practicing English on Skype. My fifth tip for making English part of your regular daily life is to join a Facebook group, forum, or website for practicing English. There's the Real Life Global Facebook group and website, as well as EnglishBaby.com. That's a social network specifically for English learners, where you can interact with other learners and teachers. Let's review the five tips I've mentioned so far, and then I'll give you one more suggestion. My first tip for making English a regular part of your life is to read or listen to the news in English, especially in the morning, so that you can start your day with some English practice. The second way is to listen to English podcasts, which is very important to improve your listening. My third tip is to think in English during the day. That's something you can do anytime, and you don't need your computer or a textbook. Fourth, practice speaking to yourself or to a partner. And finally, do social networking in English, especially if you're online a lot or you enjoy social media. And my sixth and final suggestion for making English a regular part of your life is to join the Premium Lesson Program. In this program, you'll get a new lesson set every week, including an article-based lesson, a conversation-based lesson, and an Ask the Teacher lesson. With Premium Lessons, you'll constantly be learning something new, so you can improve your English more and more. You can start and stop your subscription anytime, but if you sign up in April, you get a special price. You can register by clicking the buttons under this video or check out the links to the free sample lessons. Remember, making English part of your regular routine will skyrocket your progress, so I hope you'll put one or more of the tips in this lesson into practice. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day!